ounce for ounce, hummingbirds are the most versatile flyers in the animal kingdom and among the most fascinating creatures on the planet. On average, most hummers weigh less than a nickel, yet they're strong enough to beat their wings 10 to 80 times a second. These tiny birds have enormous appetites, and they'll often visit 1,000 flowers a day in an effort to consume half of their body weight in nectar, the precious fuel that keeps them aloft. And of course, they're geniuses in the air. Whether hovering in a fixed position or flying at almost any angle or direction, including upside down.
Hummingbirds have to be among the most fascinating birds I've ever encountered. Kind of made a lifetime avocation of studying them and filming them and getting to know them. There are 343 recognized species today, and all of them are found in North America, Central and South America.
Often described as nature's helicopters, the birds' acrobatic prowess is the result of their meticulously designed anatomies, where every movement is driven by orchestrated systems of bones, nerves, feathers, and muscles that all work together in brilliant harmony.
Hummingbirds are built for speed and maneuverability. They're zipping around, incredible aerobatics, going backwards, forward, hovering in midair. The tail is a balancing organ. It helps guide which direction they want to go. They can raise it to zoom up. They can drop it to stall. They can use it to go side to side. It's highly maneuverable. The flight muscle in a typical hummingbird represents about 43% of the body mass. That gives them the tremendous power to do these kinds of maneuvers that most birds cannot even dream of accomplishing.
Now let's use computer animation for a better understanding of how the bird performs three specialized types of flight. To fly forward, the wings flap rapidly up and down, generating thrust. Then to hover, their angle and movement are radically adjusted to create a figure-eight pattern that stabilizes the bird's body in the air. And to fly backward, the wings move in a circular path above the bird's head.
No other bird can fly like this because no other bird has a skeletal system designed to function like a hummingbird's. And this becomes obvious when you compare a hummer to a large bird like a raptor.
For a red-tailed hawk and almost every other species of bird, the mechanics of powered flight are similar. Its wings flap up and down like paddles on hinges, creating lift only on the downstroke. In contrast, while hovering, a hummingbird flaps its wings backward and forward to generate lift on both strokes.
Hummingbirds need to hover in a fixed position, meaning that they need lift all the time, and their shoulder joint provides a unique solution to the problem. It can rotate a wing 140 degrees by twisting the upper arm bone. And when the bone twists, the entire wing inverts as it's coming back up, actually to generate part of the lift that they require to maintain their stability in the air.
The hummingbird's rigorous lifestyle is also sustained by its high-performance metabolic and circulatory systems.
To keep this massive flight muscle filled with oxygen-carrying blood, the bird's heart has to beat as much as 1,250 beats a minute. Just think of the speed of the nerve synapses. I mean, all of this is being controlled by nerves firing at an incredible rate to make this possible.
hummingbird flight continues to inspire new research and discovery as innovative technologies deepen our understanding and appreciation for these flying jewels. They are truly works of art, marvels of engineering, and something more. For on a summer afternoon, a quick glimpse of their pulsing wings and flashing colors is all it takes to spark a genuine sense of God's creative power and the wonder it inspires. As the Old Testament author of Job once wrote, "But ask the animals, and they will teach you, or the birds of the air, and they will tell you, that the hand of the Lord has done all this, and in his hand is the life of every living thing."